Hello there. Now we'll discuss the theory of how addition of weight on a ship will affect the stability. Now we know that ships are basically merchant ships are basically platforms which are used to transport cargo from one place to another and in the process make money. So it is very important that the cargo and the ship being moved from one place to the other is safe, is stable throughout, right from the loading to the transportation to the unloading stage. So when we are adding a mass onto a ship, which is generally done in a port, you'll be adding some mass like cargo, fuel, or other consumables like food items or anything. So this is the time when you're adding mass, and you will be adding mass such that the addition of mass happens at some particular location of a ship. For example, for cargo, you have cargo hold or cargo tanks. For fuel, you have fuel oil tank. Lube oil has lube oil tank. Then there are stores for having various types of consumables to be kept. Suppose you are taking in ballast water, you have different types of ballast water tanks from forward end to aft end of the vessel. So the point is, you will be adding a mass at one particular location of a ship. You may not have much choice in where you can add or where you should add, for that matter. So when you add a mass, definitely that is going to change the stability of that vessel. Now that is easily studied. How the stability is affected is studied by analyzing how the center of gravity of the vessel has shifted once the mass has been added. So that is one case scenario which we are going to discuss now. Consider a vessel which is floating in water and which has the center of gravity initially at a point G. Suppose we are adding a mass W, which is the location of this added mass W is at a distance D above the original center of gravity G. Because of this addition of this weight, your new center of gravity will go up. It will go from G to G1, such that G1 is at a direction towards W from G. So that is how G1 can be located in a figure, and the distance G1 we can find out using the formula which we have already discussed, W into dy, W plus W, where small w is the added mass, capital W is the mass displacement of the vessel. Now similarly, if a weight W is added at a distance D, which is vertically below G, such that the point W, the weight W, is at a distance small d from the center of gravity G, then this will cause a lowering of the center of gravity from original center of gravity G to G1. And again, the distance G1 we can find out using this formula, W into D by W plus W. So again, as I had told you, the formula seems to be same in both these cases, both these slides, but the difference is in the location of G1. In the first case, G1 had moved up towards the point where mass was added. In this case, G1 has come down towards the point where the mass has been added, a weight W has been added. Similarly, if you can consider a case where a weight W is added at a position which is at a radial distance D from G. So your G, center of gravity, initially is located here. Radially, if you move at a distance D at somewhere at this location, you see on a ship in the side hull, you have ballast tanks where you add ballast water. And as per rule, you are not supposed to carry any fuel or cargo in your double hull. So suppose in the double hull you can carry ballast water or fresh water. You will be adding ballast water or fresh water here. So in scenarios like that, your center of gravity G will move in a direction towards W along a line joining the center of gravity W and ship. So this is a scenario. So your G1 is a new center of gravity and it will have a transverse component dx and a vertical component dy, and we can find out g1y and gg1x, which will be the shift in center of gravity in the transverse as well as vertical direction. All these values we can find out using the formulae which we have studied earlier. So this is how we can find out how the center of gravity has shifted when we are adding a mass in a vessel. So the conclusion is, the center of gravity of a body will move directly towards the center of gravity of the added weight. So this is something which we need to keep in mind. Now very quickly, let us just go through a simple example. A ship has a displacement of 2400 tons and kg 10.8 meters. Find the new kg if a weight of 50 tons is loaded at a height of 6 meters vertically above the center of gravity. So as it is recommended in all numerical questions, it will be much better if you can start your solution by constructing a figure. So you can see here a figure of a ship initially with center of gravity G, A is your keel. So as for the question, you are adding a weight W which is at a distance D above center of gravity, and this has led to your G to rise to a new point G1, and GG1 as we know is found out by the formula GG1 is W into D by W plus W. So if you apply this formula with the data given in the question, you can find out that GG1 is 0.12 meters. This is the method by which we can solve this question. So now you know when a numerical like this comes, how we can solve. So please go through this video again, and in case you have any doubts, you may always contact me in my email ID pramod.imu@gmail.com. Thank you for listening.